Bemidbar chapter 20. And the children of Israel, all the congregation, came into the wilderness of Tzin in the first new moon, and the people stayed at Kadesh. And Miriam died there, and was buried there. Now there was no water for the congregation, and they assembled against Moshe and against Aharon. And the people contended with Moshe and spoke, saying, If only we had died when our brothers died before Yahweh. Why have you brought up the assembly of Yahweh into this wilderness, that we and our livestock should die here? And why have you brought us up out of Mitzrayim, to bring us to this evil place? Not a place of grain, or figs, or vines, or pomegranates, and there is no water to drink. Then Moshe and Aharon went from the presence of the assembly to the door of the tent of appointment, and they fell on their faces, and the esteem of Yahweh appeared to them. And Yahweh spoke to Moshe, saying, Take the rod, and assemble the congregation, you and your brother Aharon, and you shall speak to the rock before their eyes, and it shall give its water. And you shall bring water for them out of the rock, and give drink to the congregation and their livestock. And Moshe took the rod from before Yahweh as he commanded him. And Moshe and Aharon assembled the assembly before the rock. And he said to them, Hear now, you rebels, shall we bring water for you out of this rock? Then Moshe lifted his hand and struck the rock twice with his rod, and much water came out, and the congregation and their livestock drank. But Yahweh spoke to Moshe and to Aharon, Because you did not believe me, to set me apart in the eyes of the children of Israel, therefore you do not bring this assembly into the land which I have given them. These were the waters of Meribah, because the children of Israel contended with Yahweh, and he was set apart among them. And Moshe sent messengers from Kadesh to the sovereign of Edom. This is what your brother Israel said, You know all the hardships that has befallen us, that our fathers went down to Mitzrayim, and we dwelt in Mitzrayim a long time, and the Mitzrites did evil to us and our fathers, and we cried out to Yahweh, and he heard our voice and sent the messenger, and brought us up out of Mitzrayim, and see, we are in Kadesh, a city on the edge of your border. Please, let us pass over through your land. We shall not pass over through fields or vineyards, nor drink water from wells. We shall go along the sovereign's highway. We shall not turn aside, right or left, until we have passed over your border. But Edom said to him, You do not pass over through me, lest I come out against you with the sword. And the children of Israel said to him, We shall go by the highway, and if I or my livestock drink any of your water, then I shall pay for it. Let me only pass over on foot, without a word. But he said, You do not pass over. And Edom came out against them with many men, and with strong hand. So when Edom refused to let Israel pass over through his border, Israel turned away from him. And the children of Israel, all the company, departed from Kadesh, and came to Mount Hor. And Yahweh spoke to Moshe and to Aharon in Mount Hor, near the border of the land of Edom, saying, Aharon is to be gathered to his people, for he is not to enter the land which I have given to the children of Israel, because you rebelled against my mouth at the water of Meribah. Take Aharon and Eleazar his son, and bring them up to Mount Hor. And strip Aharon of his garments, and put them on Eleazar his son, for Aharon is to be gathered to his people and die there. And Moshe did as Yahweh commanded, and they went up to Mount Hor, before the eyes of all the congregation. And Moshe stripped Aharon of his garments, and put them on Eleazar his son. And Aharon died there on top of the mountain. And Moshe and Eleazar came down from the mountain. And when all the congregation saw that Aharon was dead, all the house of Israel wept for Aharon 30 days.